Hey, my Regina Slayers. Okay, so we are going to show you how to customize your frontal. I do have a 20-inch HD frontal from my site. I will have the link below if anybody would like to order their HD frontals. This is what it looks like. So we will go ahead and start the customization process. So I like to flip it backwards on my canvas head. And just to put a few pins in there, I don't like to pin it too tight because it will cause over bleaching, or it will bleach on the actual hair, and you do not want that. So the products that we are using is the BW2, and I am using 40 developer. I know a few people use 30 developer. I just like to use 40 because it speeds up the process for me. I usually do about 2 scoops for the frontal, and I do not measure the developer. I usually just wean it and just figure it out as it go. But when you do mix up your developer, make sure that you do not put too much in there, because you want it to be pasty. We do not want that developer to be runny, because if it's runny, once again, it can cause that over bleaching. So as you can see, I'm still adding some more developer because it was not mixed properly. And you will see me adding a little more. Like I said, you just keep adding the developer to however you feel like it is that consistent, pasty feel. And I'll show you here. You see, it does not fall off the brush. Make sure it's very pasty like that. So when I do apply the mixture to the frontal, I always start off with the hairline. That is the most important part, is the hairline. Because you could possibly miss a spot in the back of the frontal, but no one will ever notice that. So you always got to make sure you saturate the front of that frontal with the mixture, because that is the most important part, ladies and gentlemen. Okay, so this is the frontal after about, I will say, maybe 35 minutes. My HD frontals, they bleach pretty quickly. They don't take 45 minutes to an hour. Usually, they'll be completely bleached within about 30 minutes. So, as you can see, we will just rinse that frontal off. Try to rinse all of the developer off first before you apply that shampoo. I like to go in and use a shimmer light shampoo, the purple shampoo, some people call it. It will tone the knots. If some of your knots are too brassy, it will tone it. Sometimes I like to soak that frontal in shimmer light shampoo in a little bit of water. Kind of how like you would water dip something. But it does tone those knots to give it a more natural look, as you can tell here. It looks a lot more natural. Okay, so this is the actual plucking part. You guys know I always like to go straight across their hairline first. This entire plucking segment will be in real time, so you guys can see exactly everything that I do. Once again, I like to start off across the hairline just to soften the hairline first, because most frontals come straight across. Then I like to part it behind, because once you part it, you will see that it has this hard, thick line. As you can see right across, we have the real thick line straight across. So we are just going to pluck at that, and it's going to soften that hairline up. So guys, do not be scared to pluck. Do not be scared to pluck. I know some people are scared. Some people feel like they were over plucked. most of the times when you feel like you are over plucking, you are actually under plucking. I learned it. So don't be scared to get those tweezers and get in there and pluck that hair out, you guys. Once you are done plucking a complete frontal, you should have a full hairball in your hand. Once you are done plucking a frontal properly, a complete hairball in your hand. So once again, like I said, I'm just going across that hairline, just softening it up. As you can see, as I'm plucking it, you can see the softening of it. It's not a straight line anymore. And that's what I like to do starting off. And then I always brush the hair back just to get a good look of it, to see if I need to pluck some more, to see if I need to stop plucking. You guys can randomly do this throughout because it will show you if you need to pluck more or if you don't need to pluck more. Obviously, I needed to pluck a little more. Those mid-size sides be kind of hard to pluck. It can be kind of tricky. But if you got a good eye, I promise you that you can do it. And ladies and gentlemen, make sure that you have good tweezers. Once those tweezers get dull, it is so hard to pluck those frontals. Make sure you always buy extra sharp tweezers, so when it comes to plucking, it is easier. So as you can tell, this is a small hairball just from the top of the frontal. So you can only imagine when I get done with the rest of it, how big the ball should be all together. So we are going to pluck the sides of this. The sides are usually easier. They are not as thick as the top. The top of the frontals always come thicker than the sides. I always remember that. So when I do the sides, I usually just go in and I just pluck. I just pluck straight across because, like I said, it's not as thick as the top. And these are the results of customizing the frontal. If you would like any HD lace, please hit the link below. Thank you, Regina Slayers, for watching again.